केमिकल अफेक्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, चैप्टर 14, क्लास 8। चिल्ड्रन, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी हैव थ्री अफेक्ट्स, हीटिंग अफेक्ट, मैग्नेटिक अफेक्ट एंड केमिकल अफेक्ट। हीटिंग अफेक्ट एंड मैग्नेटिक अफेक्ट यू हैव स्टडीड इन क्लास 7। नाउ इन दिस क्लास वी विल स्टडी अबाउट केमिकल अफेक्ट। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट मीनिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, then conductors and insulator, then conduction of electricity throughout liquids, and then chemical effect of electric current and electroplating and its uses. Electricity, this is an essential part of modern living. Children, nowadays you can't imagine life without electricity. So it is very, very important form of energy. It is one of the most important of all forms of energy. We have learned about the different forms of energy. These are heat energy, sound energy, kinetic energy, potential energy, solar energy, etc. It provides us with light and heat and operates a variety of machinery such as motor cars, refrigerators, television sets, ovens, pumps and heaters. Moreover, it can power the huge engines of a high-speed electric train. Children, you are seeing nowadays electric trains, these are running and turn a piece of iron into a magnet. So this is not all. In this chapter, we will learn more about the effects of electricity. Children, here you are seeing many appliances like table lamp, washing machine, refrigerator, television, speaker, AC, vacuum cleaner, all these run by electricity. Children, I think you know about matter. Matter means anything that has mass and occupies space. And the smallest part of the matter is the atom. Atom, it consists of negatively charged particles called electrons, positively charged particles called protons, and neutral particles called neutrons. Children, atom contains subatomic particles. Electron, proton, and neutron, these are subatomic particles and present inside an atom. The flow of electrons, this is called electricity or electric current. Electric current, this can be defined as the flow of charge. Out of these particles, electrons are movable. So the flow of electron, so this is called electric current. Electrons flow from negative to positive terminal, whereas current flows from positive to negative terminal. So this is called conventional direction of current. Conventional direction of current, so this is taken opposite of direction of electron. Children, you are seeing figure 14.2. Here, different electrical appliances, these are used, but the person, they are doing mistake. For example, the first figure, the boy is touching electrical socket. That is very wrong. In the B figure, the boy is touching a bucket which is getting hot water by immersion rod. The boy get electric shock. In the third figure, heater is on and the person is touching switch with wet hand. And in the fourth figure, the bulb is on, table lamp bulb is on and the person is touching it with metallic things. And in the fifth figure, the switch is on and the person is using scissor to cut it. So in the figure, all these are dealing with electricity and must take care to protect themselves from electric shock. The person here are doing mistakes. Have you ever tried to think that why your elders always warn you not to touch electric wires and switches with wet hand? In the figure C, the person is touching electrical switch with wet hand. He is doing mistake. He may get electric shock. because the water, this is a good conductor of electricity and make a connection between the electric switch and your body, resulting in flow of current and giving you an electric shock. Now the topic is conductors and insulator. Children, this topic you have already studied in the lower classes. And from the lower classes, you know conductors means those materials which allow electric current to pass through them and which provide the path to for the flow of electric current. And the insulator, these are those which don't allow electric current to pass through them. So we have already studied about conductors and insulators. Now come to the explore. Why do we not use copper wire without insulation for wiring? You have seen copper wire, it is already insulated. So that insulator don't allow electric current to pass through them. So we can easily use the copper wire without getting electric shock. Now we can find with the help of tester whether the electric current passed through the particular material or not. At home we do this. Now we do activity 2 know about conductors and insulators. Now activity 1. Aim is to study about conductors and insulator. For this activity, materials require a torch bulb that is of 1.5 volt fixed in a holder as shown in the pic, a dry cell and things like copper wire, iron wire, aluminium wire, cotton thread, rubber string, strips of paper and plastic. Now procedure or method. First of all, connect the positive and negative terminals of the cell to the two terminals of the bulb holder with the help of copper wire as shown in the figure A. Now what do you observe? The bulb glows. You will find the bulb glows. Now remove the copper wires. Again connect the cell to the terminals of the bulb holder with the help of cotton thread. Now does the bulb glow? No. This time the bulb does not glow. Next, make the connection between the bulb and the cell with the help of some other material like rubber string, strips of paper and plastic, iron wire, aluminium wire, etc. and observe in which case the bulb glows. Observation: we will observe that the bulb glows when it is connected to the cell with the help of materials like copper wire, iron wire and aluminium wire. The bulb does not glow when it is connected to the cell with the help of materials like cotton, thread, rubber string, sticks of paper and plastic. Now from this activity we can conclude that materials like copper wire, iron wire, aluminium wire allow electric current to pass through them, so they are conductors. On the other hand, materials like cotton thread, rubber string, strips of paper and plastic, they don't allow electric current to pass through them, so they are insulators. Children, we have observed an electrician working at the electric poles. He generally wears rubber gloves in his hands or uses tools which have rubber coating on their handles. Similarly, in our homes, copper wires and aluminium wires covered with thin layer of insulating material like rubber, PVC are used for electric wiring so that we can use these wires very easily without getting electric shock.